Hello friends, in this video we will study how to design the curved beams. Okay, so before going to start this design portion, so let us go for the meaning of what is a beam. Okay, so beam is a structural member whose length is large compared to its cross section. Okay? Compared to its cross section area, so it is used to support the load, okay, in the direction of transverse to the its axis. Okay? So let us consider here it is a straight beam. Here it is a straight beam of rectangular cross section. So in straight beam, what happens? So the neutral axis and centroidal axis are in a collinear or a coincident. Okay. So normally you can see the straight beam is you can observe in buildings where it has been placed below the roof to carry out the concrete load. Okay. It's supported between two columns and it is used to carry the roof load. Okay. Now, so curved beam is what? It is a deflected form of a straight beam. It is a deflected form of a straight beam. Now, this is what a straight beam. Now, this is a curved beam. Now, this is a curved beam. So, how are we going to define the curved beam? So, a member which is already has an initial curvature, already has an initial curvature because of some external bending moment or because of some stresses. Okay, so where the neutral axis as well as the centroidal axis are deflected, okay, which have a offset. Okay, so that type of beam you can call them as a curved beams. Okay, so now in this case we just observe this figure here. So now this is what a curved beam. Now this is what a curved beam. Okay, so here if you consider, the portion is not a straight line. It has been have a curvature about the center line of curvature. Center line of curvature, that is what? About this point, it has a curvature. Okay. About this point, it has a curvature. Okay. Now, so you can just, this is what a curved beam. Now, this is what a curved beam. Now this is what a neutral axis. This is what a neutral axis. Okay. So now this is what a deflected form of a curved beam. When you apply the load P, it is going to get deflected. Okay. It is going to get deflected. So now this is what a blue color arc. It is what a centroidal axis. It is what a centroidal axis. So next, this is what a neutral axis. Okay. Now deflected curved beam. Okay. Now in this case, if you consider a point here, okay, which is subjected to load P, which is subjected to load P, at a distance of L from center of curvature, Now if you consider here, so now let us consider this is the distance from neutral axis to the load point. Now let us take this point as a L. Let us take this point as a L. Okay. Now you just observe. So if you observe the distribution of stress here, for straight beam it is a linear. I think you have studied in strength of material for calculation of bending stress in beams. Okay. You are going to get this as in a straight line here. That too based on type of bending moment, it is going to be subjected, whether it is going to subjected hogging bending moment or it is subjected to sagging bending moment. Okay. So on top side you may get some tensile stress. Okay. On bottom side you may get compressive stress. Okay. Now in this case, if you observe the deflected curve, so now because of load, the portion which is here, this try to make some elongation. Okay, this portion tries to make a elongation. So now this portion try to get a compression. This portion tries to get compression. So that is what. So this curved beam, it tries to become a straight line here. It's try to become straight. So on that cases, what happens? So the internal fibers under more stretch. Okay, and external fibers under compression. Okay? Now, how to calculate the bending stress? for this curved beam. Okay, for this curved beam. So now P is a load here. L is a distance of the load point with respect to the neutral axis in plane of the critical section. That is what in plane of xx. That is what section xx. Okay. Now what are the assumptions you need to make in analysis of this curved beam? You need to consider the same assumptions what you considered in calculation of bending stress for a straight beam. Okay. That is what material is homogeneous and isotropic. Okay, material is homogeneous and isotropic. So the material obeys material of the beam obeys the Hooke's law. Young's modulus is same in tension and compression. Now each layer of the beam is free to expand or contract independent of the layer above or below it. Next, the transverse sections of the beam, which is plane before bending, remains plane even though after bending. Okay. Now, what are the stresses are going to be induced in the curved beam? Are within the elastic limit, or within the elastic limit, because it should not get any plastic deformation. If it gets plastic deformations, then the component under a failure state. Okay. Now, by considering these assumptions, so they have derived the equation to find out the bending stress in curved beam. Okay. So now the pure bending stress you are going to get in curved beam. So that is what at inner fiber, sigma I equal to M into Ci divided by A E Ri. Okay. Now similarly at outer fiber, M into Co divided by A E R naught. Now in this case, so where m equal to bending moment, m is bending moment. Okay, so C naught is the distance of outer fiber. Okay, outer fiber from neutral axis here. Okay, from neutral axis. Okay, so now E is the eccentricity, okay, or the eccentric distance between neutral axis and centroidal axis. Neutral axis and centroidal axis. So A refers to the cross sectional area of section. Okay. And one more term is there, R naught. It is the radius of outer fiber from centroidal point or from center of curvature. Okay. So now let us notify the notations here. Let us notify the notations. What are the notations you are going to use? Now the solution is done based on the design data handbook. That is what Mahadevai and Balvi Reddy referring edition 3. Okay, so little variation in formulas. Okay, now this is what the load point, that is what center of curvature. Okay, so now it is what load line. Okay, now here the distance measured from center of curvature to the, this is what radial distance to the inner surface of fiber, it is noted as a letter Ri. Okay, it is what radius of inner fiber from center of curvature, that is what Ri. Next R, it is what center of curvature of centroidal axis, radial distance. Okay, or radius of center of curvature from CZ. Okay, now this is what is center of curvature. Now we have a centroidal axis here. You have a centroidal axis. Now this is what a neutral axis. It is what, so the radius of centroidal axis from center of curvature. Next, Rn. Rn stands for the radius of neutral axis from center of curvature. Next, Ro, radius of outer axis, sorry, outer fiber from centroidal axis. Okay. Now, another important parameters here. So, the distance between CZ to the NA, it is noted as a letter E. It is what? Noted as a letter E. Now, this is what? Eccentricity, the distance between the neutral axis and the centroidal axis. Next. So, the distance from centroidal axis to the outer fiber, it is noted with the letter C2. Similarly, the distance of inner fiber from centroidal axis is noted with the letter C1. Okay. Now, C1, C2 are related to the centroidal axis, okay, or radius of centroidal axis from center of curvature. Now, in this case, here CO refers to the distance of outer fiber from neutral axis. Distance of outer fiber from neutral axis. So, next, CI refers to the distance of inner fiber from neutral axis. Distance of inner fiber from neutral axis. Now, so to get the value of Rn, to get the value of R, you need to find out the value of C1 and C2. To get the value of R, you need to find out C1 and C2. Okay. To get the value of Rn, you need to find out Ci or C0. Or you can calculate value of E. You can calculate value of E. If you know the known parameters, to get the value of E, you must have the value of Rn. So now, based on diagram, E equal to what? This is what? R minus Rn. R minus Rn, which will give the E. Okay? Which will give the E. Okay? Now, so we have one problem here. A crane hook has a trapezoidal cross section of sides 90 mm and 25 mm and a depth of 116 mm. with inner radius of curvature as 65. Determine the fibers, maximum fiber stresses developed in the hook while lifting a load of 90 kilonewton. Okay. Now, in this case, so if you consider the parameters, what they have given, okay. Now, load they have given. It is how much it is to carry 90 kilonewton. Okay. Now, this is what a load point they have provided. Okay. So, in this case, they have given L equal to RC. In this case, they have given L equal to RC. So, now we have what you noted here. So, now this L has to be from centroidal axis. Okay. Because movement is going to act at a centroidal axis, not on the neutral axis. You make a correction here. Okay. So, L is the distance of load from centroidal axis. Okay, make a correction there. Because for analysis purpose, what we are treating? So, we are treating load is going to be passes through its centroidal axis, okay, not a neutral axis, not on neutral axis. Okay. Now, so we'll go for a solution. So, now, as it is subjected to the section which is at xx, I consider a section xx, okay. Now, load point is here. Now, this section subjected to two type of stresses here. It is subjected to two type of stresses. Why? Because section is under eccentric load. Section is under eccentric load. How are you going to resolve this eccentric load? You are going to resolve this eccentric load in a two parameters. Okay. So one is you need to treat this as a direct load, as it is going to pass through the area cross section. Okay. Direct stress. Then stress due to bending. Then stress due to bending. So now to obtain the total stress or resultant stress, okay, you need to add up both. Resultant stress is what? It is summation of R equal to sigma d plus sigma b. So now this sigma b may be of from inner fiber or from outer fiber. Okay, from inner fiber or from outer fiber. Okay, so now let us go for solution. Let us go for solution. Okay. So we will note down first given data properly. Okay. So it is what? Trapezoidal section. It is what? Trapezoidal section. Okay. So let us go for capital B. Is 90 mm. Okay. Small b is a 25 mm. Its height is 116 mm. Okay. So now RI they have given. RI is 65 mm. RI is 65 mm. Okay. So load P equal to F equal to 90 kN. Okay. So what is the requirement here? You need to calculate what is the sigma max. What is the sigma max? Okay. Now, so let us go for first. We'll find out the cross section area for section. Okay, first we'll calculate cross section area of section. Okay, this is equal to what? 1/2 b × h. 1/2 b × h. So capital B. I hope this is the right equation. You just cross check. Okay. So area. Now it is, I have to take a average. Okay. Now this is for triangle. Okay. So now this is what? H divided by 2 in bracket capital B plus small b, because you need to go for average area. Okay. Now h is 116 divided by 2, capital B is 90 mm, small b is 25. Okay. So you note down how much area you are going to get. So once you got the cross section area, now you can calculate the direct stress. Now you can calculate direct stress. Okay. So let us calculate direct stress here. Now this is noted as the letter sigma d. Okay. This is equal to what? P by A or F by A. F is 90 kN. Okay, you have some area. So you note down the value here. Okay, you note down the value. Next thing. So we need to find out what is the bending stress. You need to find out what is the bending stress. Okay. Now here the thing is that if you note down the equation initially, so you come to know what are the parameters you need to calculate to get that value. Okay, to get that value. For example, so now we'll note down the equation here. One equation. Okay, that is what? Bending stress at outer fiber. Okay, outer fiber. Let us go for this is a sigma BO. What is the equation? Equation is M into C naught divided by CO divided by AERO. Okay. AERO. Now the thing is that you need to find out what is the bending moment. You need to find out what is the distance of outer fiber from the neutral axis already have calculated cross sectional area. You need to find out value of E, then R naught. Okay, so let us go for calculation of the eccentric distance. Eccentric distance. Eccentric distance, okay, or the radial distance between the radius of centroidal axis and neutral axis. This is what E equal to R minus Rn. R minus Rn. Okay. So now to get the value of Rn, okay. So you need value of C1 and C2. You need value of C1 and C2. So let us notify equation. So refer design data handbook. Okay. So I think equation number. Now we need to refer table here. Refer table. Okay. Now, as I'm doing third edition, so you refer figure number 7. Sorry, table number 10.1. Table number 10.1 and figure number 7. Figure number 7. That means how the value has been taken. For reference, you refer figure number 7. Okay. Now R. Now I will write equation for Rn here. I will write equation for Rn. So it is a bigger equation. A divided by, okay, small b, okay, in bracket R plus C2, bracket close, minus capital B. Now they have gone for B1 here. I will write B1 small b in bracket R plus C2 bracket close divided by H. This is in square bracket. Entire thing is in a square bracket. Next, into ln natural logarithm R plus C2 divided by R minus C1, okay, sorry, R plus C2, okay, R plus C1 here, minus capital B1 small b1. Now, accordance with data handbook, with reference to our cross section, B1 refers to 90 mm, okay. So small b refers to 25 mm, okay. So H refers to 116 mm, okay. 116 mm. Okay. So now R plus C2 is going to give the value of R naught. So R naught can be calculated by this diagram as Ri plus H. Ri is 65 mm, okay, plus H is 116 mm. I think you are going to get this value as 1181 mm. Okay. Now R plus C1, okay. So we need to check this equation whether it is right or wrong. Please verify your data handbook. I think that has to be R minus C1. Okay. Wait, I'm checking data handbook. So that has to be r minus c1, okay? So I will just alter the equations, okay? So just alter the equation, okay? So b1 r plus c2 minus b, okay, r minus c1 here, okay, this is what r minus c1, okay, r minus c1 minus b1 plus b. So now if you look over the section here that is what the cross section. So otherwise I'll draw here one more section. You will draw a section here. Okay, better to draw here. So now I'll draw the section here. Okay, I'll draw the section. Okay, drawing of the section XX. Okay. Now here, section XX. Okay. So this is what RI, they have given it is 65 mm. Now H they have given, so 116 mm. Then you can calculate the value of R0. So R0 equal to what? RI plus H, this is equal to 116 plus 65 mm. I think this is 181 mm. Okay. Now, so you need to calculate the value of R here. Okay, you need to calculate value of R. So now as R I is given, you need to find out value of C naught here. Sorry, you need to find out value of C1 to get the value of R here. Okay. So how will get the value of R? Now let us notify this distance as a E here. Okay. Now this portion is C I. This portion is C naught. Okay, now value of R, particularly in this case, okay, this is what R I plus C 1. Sorry, wait a minute. I drawn wrong. Now here, okay, this is what C 1. R equal to R I plus C 1 here. Okay. So now how will get the value of C1? Okay. So to get the value of C1, you need to refer chapter number 1. You need to refer chapter number 1. Okay. So for section, you have some equations to find out the value of C1 and C2. That is what I think in table, first chapter table. Let us wait, I will mention the table number here. That is what stress analysis. Okay, so you need to refer chapter number 1. Chapter number 1, table number 1.3A. Okay, so refer design data handbook. Okay, so refer table number 1.3A. Okay, 1.3A. So to get the value of C1, okay. So they have given diagram in this way for trapezoidal sections. They have given diagram in this way. Okay. Now this is what overall height here. Now this is what rotated in terms of 90 degrees. This is what edge. Okay. Now according to your notations. Now this is what C, this is equal to C2. Okay, now they have given C in table number 1.3. Next, so on bottom portion, for bottom width, they are not given any notations here. Okay, then for top portions, they have took this as a B. Okay, this is what B0/2. This is what B0/2. Okay. Now, this distance is how much? 90 here. Now, B is 25. Okay. You must take care while using some values here. Okay. Now, B equal to how much? 25. Okay. Now B naught equal to what? B naught equal to 90 minus B. Let us take this as a capital B here for your understanding purpose. Capital B minus small b. Okay. So 90 minus 25, you are going to get some value here. I think 65. Now B0/2 is what? 65/2. Now we are going to get this value as a 32.5. Now to get the value of C from data handbook, C equal to, write the equation, C equal to 3B, okay, plus 2B0, it is bracket close, into H, divided by 3 in bracket 2b plus b naught. Now according to this one, value is 3 into 25 here, okay, plus 2 into b naught, how much you got here? 65, okay, divided by 3 into B, in bracket B is 25 again here, B naught is 65. Okay. This is multiplied with a H here. Now you are going to get a value of C. Now this is equal to what? C equal to C2. Sorry, it is a C2, not a G2. Okay. It is C2. What you got from above? You are going to get C equal to C2. Okay. Now to calculate the value of C1, okay, C minus C2, you will get the value of C1. Okay. Now add R equal to Ri plus C1. Okay. Substitute this value of R, okay, in this equation. Now possibly in this case, okay. Now R plus C2 equal to what? You can substitute here as R0 So here you can substitute as Ri, because R minus C1 equal to Ri. Okay, already you come across R equal to what? Ri plus C1. Okay, so R not equal to at R equal to, okay, R equal to R not minus C2, right? So R not equal to what? R plus C2. You can substitute here. So here also you can substitute R not. So here also you can substitute Ri. Okay. Now in this case, B1 equal to 25 mm, B equal to 90 mm. Okay. If you solve this one, you are going to get a value of Rn. You are going to get a value of Rn. Now once you got the value of Rn, now you calculate R. R you can calculate now. You got a value of C1. Okay. So R you can get from Ri plus C1. Okay. Rn you can get from equation there. Okay. Equation. What is the equations? Equation A divided by B R 2 plus. So you have some equation here. Then ln of R naught minus Ri in bracket minus B1 plus B. So all those things. You are going to get a Rn. So now you calculate value of E. E equal to R minus Rn. You will get E. Once you got the value of eccentricity, then you calculate Ci. Okay. Now we'll calculate Ci. Ci equal to what? The distance of inner fiber from neutral axis. Okay. This is what Ci. Ci equal to you can go for C1 minus E. Okay. C1 minus E. How? You just look out diagram here. Okay. So now Ci is here. Okay. Ci equal to what? C1 here minus E. You will get this distance is what Ci. Now similarly, the distance of inner fiber, okay, inner fiber from neutral axis, outer fiber from neutral axis. This is what C naught equal to what? C naught equal to C2 plus E, okay, C2 plus E. Now just look out here. Now this is a C naught here. Okay. Up to this stage it is a C2. Now here it is a E. What will get? C naught equal to C2 plus E. Okay. C2 plus E. Right? Now once you got the value of Ci and C naught, you calculate the bending stress. Okay. Now we'll calculate bending stress. Now for this case, you are going to get a tensile bending stress. At inner fiber. Okay. Now sigma bi equal to m ci divided by ae ri. Now to calculate the bending moment M here. M, okay, this is equal to what? L into P or L into F. Now in this case, L equal to R. In this case, L equal to R. Okay. So now you will get R into P or R into F is the bending moment. I think you got all value here. I think you got all value. Now similarly calculate the bending stress. At outer fiber. This is of nature compressive. Okay. Now we will get a minus here. minus m c naught divided by a e r naught. Okay, next, the resultant bending stress at outer fiber sigma b r o. Okay, resultant, this is what, sigma d plus sigma b o. Next, the resultant bending stress at inner fiber, okay, sigma b r I. Now this is what, sigma d into sigma b I. Now this is the magnitude is minus here, okay? Magnitude is minus. So you follow these steps, you are going to get the answer. Okay?